of course, women have been disappointed. Like today you say there will be elections and tomorrow you cancel, and some women don't actually know the reason why.
Rose Kajubu, a woman leader from Fort Poto, says that the suspension of the exercise was timely because a few people had been sensitized about the exercise.
And I thank them to stop this exercise because it was not going to be in a proper way. They were going to vote people which they are supposed not to be voted.
Dorcas Kasande says that although the suspension of the election was disappointing, it gives leverage and more time to the women to mobilize the community. She has called for patience among women leaders and also challenged the government to do more civic education.
It gives also the government more time to actually civilize people, I mean educate people about the elections, the purpose of women leadership.
Irene Junda, a woman leader, says that the suspension of the exercise affects the women's involvement in government programs as a special interest group.
People with disabilities, elections, they are all over. Now they are in offices working. But for women, we come after. It means the government is not yet put much effort to the women leadership. Yes, they give us power, they give us rights to participate in such things, but we want this office to be open.
Betty Mujungu, a female counselor in Fort Poto, has stressed the need for mindset change and empowerment to encourage women to take up leadership positions.
I've been in the process of encouraging women to come up for these positions because there's a lot of laxity in taking up these positions. Like in some of the villages that we've been to, women say, they thought voting was done when they voted in 2021, that was it.
She observes that despite the significance of the women's leadership positions, most women are shying away because of poor mindset.
It is a mindset issue. And this is what we are doing to help mindsets, to change the mindset about the position. It is a position that doesn't have money, but it is a position that decides so much or that matters to women that much.
Slivia Kugonza, a woman activist, says that women councils would have been relevant only if they were benefiting the local people. She has blamed the Electoral Commission for being ill-prepared in organizing and holding the Women Council elections.
Would have been relevant in case women are benefiting from those councils. We've been having elections for women councils, but guess what? What us as women have we benefited from those councils?
Patrick Kebisembo, a resident of Fort Poto, says that due to poor mobilization of office bearers, women councils have lost meaning despite the good intended motive of establishing them.
Could go and educate people about the use of this women council. For me, when I read about the act and the genesis of the Women Council, it's supposed to benefit the women from the grassroots about the services that the government has, particularly for women.
This story was compiled by Roger Sande for the news.